Good morning, YouTube. Guess what? It is F1 day. So today is Sunday, the 22nd, and the F1 races are here in Austin. And so I have a ticket, and I have a bit of an interesting situation. So Dylan, the guy who had the violin thing that you saw recently, or maybe you didn't see because you're all, I want to watch violin. Anyway, he invited me to come to his suite at F1. I'm not kidding. So I'm a little bit like, holy shit, I should probably go do this. So I actually wasn't going to go to F1 because it's kind of a clusterfuck. And I'd rather watch on TV because you get to see more of the action. But to go see it in a suite, frankly, if I would have gotten a grandstand ticket, anything like that, you know, I just don't want to spend that much money to go sit on the grass, which, it was raining really hard this morning, and we had a thunderstorm and all sorts of great stuff. So it might be a mud fest. It's going to be an interesting day. So let's go to F1, probably see some pretty awesome stuff, hopefully get up into that suite, have a good day, and then get stuck in traffic trying to get home. So should be a good day. I'm excited. Let's get going. I'm in the suite, thanks to Dylan. This is Dylan.
Hey.
Can you believe this? I'm in the suite. So there's some old school F1 cars coming around that scream, so we're gonna film those. They just finished up F4, and then F1's not till like 2 o'clock or something like that. So what a crazy day.
Amazing, this is gonna be a great race.
Oh yeah. All right, I'm in the suite by myself because Dylan had to run, do something real quick, but I'm assuming other people will be coming very, very soon. How amazing is this, dude? I don't know how the hell some of these things are happening to me, but I'm not gonna complain. I mean, come on, but it's pretty amazing, look at this. Like, got crazy good views, like, oh, this is unbelievable. And then of course we do have the TV right there, so you'll be able to watch the TV and see the race, because that's one of the things I don't like about being at the races, is you don't get to see a lot of the action, because you know they're never passing right in front of you. You never get that lucky. It's always somewhere down the track, you know, whatever. But I think I'm gonna grab some lunch because I'm starving. But this is amazing. Dylan, you're my hero, and your family is amazing too. So all right, I'm gonna keep doing this. Enjoy my day.
Going into the target.
Yeah!
awesome. Unfortunately, Fry did not win, but we got second and third. I'm heading down to the Velocity Lounge to meet up with Rex, schmooze a little, and then fight traffic home. Sorry, walking downstairs, don't want to fall. But pretty good race. Thank you again, Dylan. What an amazing day. What an amazing day. It was absolutely amazing. So, all right. I'm gonna get to the Velocity Lounge.
All right, I gotta make the long trek home. I'll show you how far I have to go. It sucks. I gotta walk like a half hour.
In case you're wondering, turn one's hill is super, super tall and steep and winded. Still only halfway up. So a word of advice, if you're parking in the grass lots, bring a four-wheel drive vehicle. I'll show you why. Oh yeah.
Ferrari Forester and the nice mud ruts I had to drive through. It's swamped in, so hopefully I can get out of this.
Just a wee bit of traffic to deal with. It's okay. I've actually made it out of the lot in about 5 minutes, which is like not too bad. You can hear all the mud kicking up, but let's see how long it takes me to get home. Oh, just got home. All right, so traffic wasn't too ridiculous. I'm kind of happy with that. It took me, I don't know, an extra probably 15 minutes, maybe even 20 compared to normal to get home from COTA. So not bad considering there was a crap load of people out there. But okay, so first of all, thank you, Dylan. That was simply amazing. I know it's like bucket list stuff for people, and I am super, super honored that you asked me to come up to your suite and watch F1, because holy crap, that was awesome. Secondly, I have to thank Jack. So, quick little story. I was looking for tickets for F1, because I didn't have tickets earlier this week. So I went on Craigslist, found a guy selling tickets, emailed him, said, hey, would you take this much money for the tickets and the parking pass? Turns out the dude was Jack. He's one of my viewers. And he's like, Dan Hurlbert? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, it's Jack. And I'm like, oh my God. So anyway, that was hilarious. And thank you, Jack. He hooked me up with a really good price on the tickets. So that was awesome. Yeah, man. I don't know what to say. Like, this is some crazy stuff going on where I keep getting all these interesting opportunities, and I'm just thankful as hell because I don't know. I don't know what I did to deserve it, but I'm going to, you know, gladly accept these wonderful offerings that people have made to me. So I'm quite humbled, and I don't know if I'm deserving of it. I mean, I try and do good things, but whatever. So I'm trying. Anyway, I'm so tired. I still gotta go get groceries. I think I'll take the Ferrari to get groceries, because fuck it, why not? You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe, watch that video, give me the thumbs up. Give Dylan and Jack the thumbs up. They both deserve it. They are awesome people, and we'll be doing more car stuff. It'd be great. We'll see you soon.